देखो
हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज निकिता शेटवार, मॉडरेटर ऑफ एस्ट्रोवेदिक एंथुजियास्ट एफबी ग्रुप, एंड टुडे वी आर हियर टू हैव अ इंटरेस्टिंग डिस्कशन ऑन अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक इन एस्ट्रोलॉजी, व्हिच इज हाउ टू सर्वाइव साडे सती ऑफ सैटर्न. एंड टू एनलाइटन अस मोर अबाउट द सेम, वी हैव अ वेरी नॉलेजेबल गेस्ट विद अस, भावाजीत कलिता from exotic astrology. So first of all, I want to thank you, Babaji, for being with us, and we are truly privileged to have you here.
Thank you very much for inviting. Pleasure is mine.
Yes. So the same is with us. And before we start with our main topic, I would like to introduce our guest, Babaji. So basically, Babajit is a born Indian who belongs to the state of Guwahati, Assam, India. Since 2015, he has been living in Göttingen, Germany, where he is pursuing the Master's in Applied Computer Science from the University of Göttingen. And he graduated with the Master's degree in July 2018. Currently, he is gonna start working with a software company from 1st of May. And another interesting thing about Babajit is that he started learning and practicing about different terms in astrology and spirituality since 2003. After which, he opened his own YouTube channel, Exotic Astrology, on 5th March 2017, which is growing in popularity day by day. So, as I said, we are very glad to have you here, Babaji. And now the show is all yours. You can please share whatever you want.
Whatever questions you have on Sade Sati, I will just try my best to answer. And thank you very much to you and Zen Madam also for sending me the invitation. So, let's open Sade Sati.
Yeah, with the blessings of Saturn, of course.
Yes, of course. And today is also Thursday. Very nice.
Very nice, yeah. So let's just start with, what is the role of Saturn in Sade Sati?
Yeah, so for those, of course, Sade Sati, everybody knows what Sade Sati is. So there are different categories of people who have heard, like one category who doesn't know anything about astrology, but they have just heard Sade Sati. So they just know that it is something in astrology. They don't know what it is. They don't know dashas, transit, nothing. But they just know it's a horror period which comes for some time. They don't even know that Sade Sat means 7.5 years. Okay, so that is one category of people. And the other category of people is they also don't have much knowledge of astrology, but they will see transit videos because they know their Rashi. And somebody told them 30 years back that your Rashi defines you completely. So they will check, from my Rashi where Saturn is transiting, okay? So for them, they just know Saturn is related with Sade Sati and something like that. And those who know about astrology in depth, they know that Sade Sati is actually a transit of Saturn for 7.5 years. And as we know, Saturn stays in one sign for almost 2.5 to 3 years. So Saturn, when it enters the 12th house from your natal moon in your horoscope, then your first phase of Sade Sati begins. And then when it enters exactly over your natal moon, then the second, and then the third phase is when it's in the second house from your moon. So that's what Sade Sati is essentially. Now, before speaking exactly what Sade Sati is, I will tell you what people think it is. So what people have done is, what people think is Sade Sati is so powerful that it can make or destroy you. They think like this. People think that anything bad which has happened to their life, bad according to them or according to society or according to anybody, during those 7.5 years. Now, if you take any average person's life, is it possible that any one person among the 7 billion people for 7.5 years, is there anybody in this world who will never have any problem for 7.5 years? it's highly impossible. That cannot happen. To assume that you will never have, what to speak of 7.5 years. I have problems every 7.5 hours. We have problems 7.5 days, 7.5 weeks, 7.5 months. Yes. In fact, every day we have some problem or the other. And we may have major issues in 7.5 years. Like somebody may have some serious health issues. Somebody may get a divorce. Somebody may be fired. Somebody may go bankrupt. These things could happen. So what people think, Sade Sati, is that it is just a net where they can put all the blames, you know. Okay, what to do, you know. Nothing is going to happen. Why? Because I am running Sade Sati. And I have seen people who do not know anything about astrology. They know astrology from a distance. Even they know. Even they, when something happens, like I have some relatives or family members, they don't know anything about astrology. But whenever there is a problem, they'll say, maybe my Sade Sati is going on. So even before the problem comes, they will put the blame on Sade Sati. Okay. So this is like a overhyped transit. But unfortunately, this is like just another transit. Another transit means, like, planets are always transiting over sun, moon, you know, ascendant or ascendant lord. So this is just another transit of the moon, of Saturn over the moon. Now the question is, why this has been given so much importance? For that we have, now there is another extreme about Sade Sati. This is one extreme which I told you. The another extreme about Sade Sati is that, oh, Sade Sati is there, what's the big deal, you know? It's like, kuch nahi hoga, nothing's there. It's just Sade Sati, doesn't matter. It's just another transit, kuch nahi hoga, forget it. It's just another day. That is another extreme. Yeah. So it is neither of this extreme nor of that extreme. Sade Sati is an important transit, but it is not the way people think it is, which means it does not have the power to make you or break you completely. But the question is then, what decides you will be made or you will be broken? Well, the answer is very simple. That is what your dasha says. Because transits are general for many people. So for example, let's talk of the current transit. Saturn is in Sagittarius.
Yeah.
So that means people who have moon in Scorpio, Sagittarius and Capricorn, their Sade Sati is going on now. These three categories. So that means any point of the time, 1/3 of the people of this world will run Sade Sati, any point of the time. So does it mean that all of these 1/3, you know, from the 7 billion, they will always have problems? No, it's not like that. The answer is, your what happens to you in your life is decided by the dasha, not by the transit. The rule is very simple, that the Mahadasha is most powerful. Then Antardasha is less powerful than that. Pratyantara is even less powerful. And then comes transits. So when something bad has happened to you in Sade Sati, apparently, or so-called bad thing which you call it, it is not because of Sade Sati. It is because the dasha is telling that it will happen to you. Okay?
Okay.
But the question is, then what Sade Sati does? See, to understand Sade Sati, you have to understand what Saturn is actually. And if you want to understand what Saturn is, you have to understand Sun and Moon. If you do not understand Sun and Moon, you can never understand what Saturn is. And you have to understand the Bhagavad Gita. These three principles you must understand. Sun, Moon and the Bhagavad Gita. Otherwise, you will just keep bluffing. Oh, my Saturn is here, Saturn is there, Saturn is doing this, Saturn is doing that. So now what does the Gita say? The Gita says that the Gita and scriptures in general, the Vedic scriptures, they say that the living entity, which is pure soul, which is represented by Jupiter in astrology, Guru as they say, that soul is trying to be somebody in this material world. And that being somebody is the sun actually. And how does the soul feel about being that somebody? That is the moon.
Yeah.
And sun is the king. We know all the planets are going around the sun. And that's why Sun shows to the degree this world will revolve around us, to that degree. That is why they have you seen in India, they will say traditionally that if Sun is exalted, it is in the 10th house, it's in Lagna, it's very powerful, then maybe you end up in the government, right? They say like this.
Right.
The question is, what happens when you are in the government? Then people are roaming around you, right?
Perfect.
Yeah. So that is why they say that Sun is the indicator of name and fame, because that's how Sun behaves. All the planets, you see, when a planet goes very far from the Sun, then what happens? It gets retrograde. No, you can't go beyond a certain extent. After that, the Sun will pull you back. No, come back. So, to the extent you can pull others, that's what the Sun shows. Because no other planet can pull anybody else. You know, I mean, of course, gravity and all this is there, but retrogression is primarily defined how? By to the extent that planet is far away from the Sun, right? So that's what the Sun is. So everybody has a kingdom in this world. Like, I have a kingdom. Maybe I am a husband. You know, I have my wife. I have children. You know, I have some employees. Now you may think that, maybe I don't have, I'm not like Alexander the Great. I don't have a big kingdom. But no, we still have a kingdom. For me, this mobile is my kingdom. I can do anything I want with this mobile. I can keep this. I can break this. I can throw it. I can donate it. I can call somebody.
Yeah.
So this is like my kingdom. I decide what I do with this mobile. I can do whatever I want with this room. Of course, later on I have to pay the price. That's different. But if I want, I can just break something now. Yes. So you are a president or a prime minister or you are a beggar. Irrespective of your financial situation, you always have a territory to rule. So that's what the Sun is. But now suppose you have a territory, big, small, whatever it is. But the question is, how do you feel about it? That is what the moon is. That is why they say the moon is the most important planet in astrology. And Sade Sati is only linked to the moon, not to the sun. And we know that sun is the worst rival of Saturn, right? I mean, they are the most rivals. Their rivalry is even considered to be more than the so-called rivalry of Jupiter and Rahu to some extent. But then why do they say that this so-called dreaded transit of Saturn is seen from the moon? Why not from the sun? Ideally, when Saturn would have been in 12th or over or second from the sun, then this should have been a very deadly transit, right? But the rishis do not say like that. The rishis say, no, moon is more important. Why? Because suppose you have a big kingdom. You have 100 people who listen to you every day and say, yes, sir, salute you. You are great, sir. Yes. But then suppose due to some reason, you don't feel that your kingdom is worth living. There are many people who have many things, but they are not happy. So that is millions of times more miserable than not having a kingdom. So that is why when Saturn's Sade Sati comes, it is seen from the moon. It is not seen from the sun. So when Saturn transits, when this similar transit happens over the sun, for example, suppose somebody has sun in Sag or Scorpio or Capricorn for now, then they could feel something similar like Sade Sati, but that will not be exactly the same. What they will feel is that, okay, my empire is under threat. But those who have moon in these three signs, they will feel not only my empire is under threat, but my happiness is under threat. Because I am not happy in my empire. Yes. So that is what Saturn is the enemy of the sun and moon, because Saturn is what basically? Saturn shows your limitation. So if you see the sign Leo and Cancer, which is the sign which is opposite? It is Capricorn and Aquarius, seven houses.
Exactly.
And both the signs are ruled by Saturn. So that means in one word, if you want to describe what Saturn is, it is basically the opposition which sun and moon faces in this world. You want to be somebody like the sun, but everybody wants to be somebody, right? Everybody wants 1,000 likes in Facebook. Everybody wants 1,000,000 subscribers in YouTube. Everybody wants 10 million followers in YouTube, in Instagram. Yes, so many other places. Everybody wants that. People should clap hands, you know, when I have some success. And everybody wants that the moon, that I should be happy. I should feel worthy as an individual. And when everybody tries to do that, then there is, you know, like if you take a paper and you make different circles there, then all the circles are cutting each other. Have you seen? So that's what happens right. When sun and moon are trying to, you know, establish a kingdom here. Everybody is trying to establish a kingdom. And there I go to the last point, which I said about Bhagavad Gita. So there Lord Krishna says, Mana shasthani indriyani prakriti sthani karshati, that the living entity is suffering every moment in this material world because it is doing karshati, means work 24 hours. And there, of course, Krishna also says that when you look to me, when you worship me, then you can gradually overcome the suffering. Devi esha gunamai mama maya durateya. That's what Krishna says. So that is why moon is always more important than the sun. Because moon can tell you, irrespective of the size of your empire, how do you feel about it? So that is why Sade Sati is more important to be seen from the moon. And that's how it is defined. All right. So now the question is, what exactly happens in Sade Sati? Why do people fear it so much? Now there are many statements in the classics about which I will not discuss here. Like there are some classics and there are many interpretations of the classics. You know, some classics say that when Sade Sati starts, you know, the first symptom is one of the elders in your family, they will pass away. All right. These are some of the things which are said, which will apply to people as per their dasha and transits, of course. But in general, what happens in Sade Sati? Imagine that everything is fine in life. You know, everything is going the way you want. There are some disappointments, but still everything is fine. And you are just sleeping on the bed. Very easily you are sleeping. You are sleeping nicely. And suddenly somebody knocks the door and your sleep breaks suddenly. And then you open the door and that person comes with a list. And that person says, excuse me, sir. These are the things you must do before sleeping. So you will feel, what the hell, man? I just went to sleep. I was just about to hit that alpha state where I'm almost gone. That time this person has come and he is waking me up. And he's telling, not only that you cannot sleep, you must do these things before you sleep. So that means I have to start working in the night now. So when do I sleep? I can't sleep, you see. So that is the first indication that Sade Sati has started or it is going to start. You feel life is not like the way it was before. That is the first indication. Because this person is not letting you sleep. Because you sleep every day, right? Every night you sleep 5 hours, 6 hours, 8 hours. But suppose today suddenly you cannot sleep because of some reason. Because you got to pay the bills. So that's the first indication that you are undersized. Now, there are many technical things to be seen here. For example, they say that this Sade Sati, which we saw from moon, the three houses, it is calculated as, suppose somebody's moon is in 15 degrees. So technically, Sade Sati is 45 degrees ahead and behind, because that's like, you know, exactly degree wise. So suppose somebody's moon is not in 15 degrees, somebody's moon is in Capricorn, suppose, and it is in 5 degrees, then his Sade Sati will start when not Sagittarius, when it is before in Scorpio only, because then, you know, degree it will go there.
True.
Yeah. And suppose somebody's moon is in 5 degrees of Capricorn, then his Sade Sati will get over also accordingly because it started earlier. Okay. So that degreekally you have to make that calculation that exactly where your moon is, from there you calculate 45 degrees. So that is what I wanted to say about Sade Sati. And we can move on to the next questions, I guess.
Yeah, so this was a unique information introduction, I would say. So now let's move ahead. How to see if the effects of Sade Sati will be mild or a bit harsh, or we can say bad. So what points we have to consider to look for in a chart?
Yeah, so they are very clear-cut answers to these questions, luckily. Okay,
Oh,
and
okay.
these are not answers like, okay, your Saturn is exalted, you'll have a good Sade Sati. Your moon is exalted, you'll have a good Sade Sati. Your moon is in exaltation, but it is in Dusthan. Your Sade Sati will be good and bad. Oh my God, so many rules. And at the end, nothing works. So
Yeah.
the first rule, this was, it is, and it will be.